In this lecture, we will discuss what is profit ratio and how we can calculate profit ratio, and then the factors which cause the change in this profit ratio. Assalamu alaikum, students. Today we are going to discuss net profit ratio, or currently the name of this ratio is changed and now this is profit ratio. In this lecture, we will discuss what is profit ratio and how we can calculate profit ratio, and then the factors which cause the change in this profit ratio. So now we start from net profit or profit for the year. Profit for the year or net profit is calculated by subtracting expenses from gross profit and adding other incomes to the gross profit. So the answer will come is that net profit or profit for the year. If you want to check in the form of formula, or you want to take the formula of profit for the year, it is very simple. That is gross profit, add other incomes, and then subtract expenses. Now, what is profit ratio, profit margin, or net profit ratio, or net profit margin? The formula of net profit ratio or profit margin is profit for the year over revenue or sales into 100 or times 100. I am repeating the formula: profit for the year over revenue or sales times 100. This will give you the answer in the percentage form. So this is the net profit ratio or profit margin. This will provide the percentage of profit which is earned by the business in that year, and we can use this ratio to compare the performance of the business, and also we can compare the business performance with other competitors in the industry, and we can compare the performance with past years. Now come to the factors which affect the net profit margin. There are two factors which may which affect the profit margin or net profit ratio or profit ratio. The first factor is expenses to revenue ratio. Remember one thing: not only expenses will affect the profit ratio or profit margin, but expenses to revenue ratio will affect the profit margin or profit. If profit is if expenses are increased, they may not affect the profit margin until unless the ratio of expenses as compared to revenue or as compared to sales is not increased. When the expenses to revenue ratio is increased, then net profit margin or profit margin will increase. Sorry, net profit margin will decrease. Now move to the effect of expenses to revenue ratio. Expenses to revenue ratio have the inverse relationship with the profit margin, means when expenses to revenue ratio is increased, then net profit margin will decrease. Okay. And when expenses to revenue ratio decreased, then net profit margin or profit margin will increase. Remember one thing: expenses to revenue ratio is inversely proportional or have inverse relation with the profit margin. Again, I am repeating, when expenses to revenue ratio will increase, then profit margin will decrease. And when revenue to expenses to revenue ratio is decreased, then net profit margin or profit margin will increase. So again, I am repeating my words and defining the relationship with profit margin and expenses to revenue ratio. Profit margin and expenses to revenue ratio is have inverse relation. Hopefully you got this point. The second factor which affect the profit margin is the gross profit ratio or gross margin. Gross margin or gross profit ratio directly affect the profit margin or net profit ratio. Means gross profit margin have direct relationship with the net profit margin or profit margin. If gross profit ratio or gross margin increased, then net profit will increase. And if gross profit margin in a specific year decreased, then net profit margin will also decrease. So I hope you got these two factors and these two points which directly affect the profit margins they affect the profit margins. Expenses to sales ratio have the inverse relation with the profit margin, and gross profit ratio have the direct relation with the profit margin. Now I'm taking two examples. In first example, I will consider change in the expenses to revenue ratio or expenses to sales ratio. I am taking 3 years details of income statement of a business. First 2017, the revenue was 400,000, cost of sales 200,000, gross profit is 200,000, and then expenses were 150,000, and the profit for the year or net profit come 50,000. Now we are calculating a gross profit margin or net profit ratio or profit ratio, which will come 12.5%, and this is very easy to calculate. Just take 50,000 profit for the year and divide it by revenue, which is 400,000, and times 100. The answer will come 12.5%. In 2018, details of revenue 440, revenue is increased, cost of sale is increased, gross profit also increased, expenses increased, and profit for the year is also increased. But the net profit margin or profit ratio is 12.5%. Look on these two figures. Even revenues increased, gross profit increased, expenses increased, profits are increased, but there is no change in the profit ratio or net profit ratio. Basically, net profit ratio describes the profit as a percentage of revenue. Means the business is earning the same percentage of revenue in the form of profit. So do not consider the increase in expenses and decrease in profit margin concept. Means if the expenses are increased, doesn't mean the net profit ratio or profit ratio will decrease. You should calculate first profit ratio and then decide either it is decreased or increased, because the profit ratio will be affected by the expenses to revenue ratio, not only expenses. Now, expenses to revenue ratio is 37.5% in 2018 and in 2017. Okay, That's why there is no increase in net profit ratio or profit ratio, because expenses to revenue ratio remain the same. And remember one thing, in this example, I did not change gross profit ratio because I want to discuss the effect of expenses to revenue ratio on the profit for the year or profit ratio. Here, expenses in these 2 years, expenses to revenue ratio remains same, gross profit ratio remains same. That's why no change in profit ratio or net profit ratio, because expenses to revenue ratio is the same in both years, and similarly gross profit ratio remains same in these 2 years. In third year, 2019, the change in revenue again increased, cost of sale increased, gross profit increased, expenses are also increased, and profit for the year remains same as 2018. And here the net profit ratio decreased, and now it is 11%. Now check. If you check the expenses to revenue ratio, that is 39%. This is the reason to decrease in the net profit ratio, because expenses to revenue ratio increased. And I told you, expenses to revenue ratio have inverse relation with the profit ratio. When expenses to revenue ratio will increase, profit ratio will decrease. Here I am telling you how you can create expenses to revenue ratio. It is very easy formula. Take the expenses divided by revenue times 100. That will give you the expenses to revenue ratio. Means expenses over revenue. Revenue means sales. Expenses over revenue times 100. And the answer will be the expenses to revenue ratio. And if you check a gross profit ratio, and gross profit ratio or gross margin have the formula gross profit over revenue into 100. In all these 3 years, the gross profit ratio remained the same, and which is 50%. In 2017, gross profit ratio or gross ratio is 50%. In 2018 and 2019, the gross profit ratio remained the same. It is 50%. And the change in profit ratio or net profit ratio is solely dependent on the expenses to revenue ratio. And you can easily get the concept. When expenses to revenue ratio will increase, then profit ratio or net profit ratio will decrease. And vice versa, when expenses ratio will decrease, expenses to revenue ratio will decrease, automatically profit ratio or net profit ratio will increase. So this is the first factor which affect the net profit ratio or net profit ratio. Now move to the second factor. In this example, I will take expenses to revenue ratio constant, and will vary the gross profit ratio. And you can easily understand how gross profit ratio will affect the profit ratio or net profit ratio. Same years, 2017, revenue figures are similar. In this situation, these are revenue, and this is the net profit ratio or profit ratio, which is 12.5%. 2017 in this example have the same figures as in previous example. Here the gross profit ratio is 50%. We will calculate later. Just take the year 2018. Here gross profit ratio, and then gross profit and expenses, and then profit for the year, which is decreased 50,000. In 2017, profit for the year was 50,000, which is net profit. And in 2018, 47,500. Now check here the profit ratio or net profit ratio, which is 10.3%. Now move to the gross profit margin or gross profit ratio. In 2018, it is 48%, and in 2017, the gross profit ratio was 50%. Look at these figures. Gross profit ratio decreased by 2%, and similarly, profit ratio or net profit ratio is decreased. And remember one thing, the decrease in gross profit ratio will not equal to the decrease in profit ratio, net profit ratio. But if gross profit ratio is decreased, then net profit ratio will also decrease. But the decrease, there is no any rule, the decrease in both ratio will be same. Here, gross profit ratio is decreased by 2%, but net profit ratio or profit ratio is decreased by 2.2%. Yes. Yes, 2.2%. Now, move to 2019. Here, the value of revenue, then cost of sale, subtract the cost of sale to get the gross profit, which is 245,000. Gross profit is increased. Value of gross profit is increased, but now expenses are this, and then profit for the year is 57,500, and here net profit ratio increased to 11.5% as compared to 2018. And if you check, the gross profit ratio in this situation is 49%. So gross profit ratio is increased from 2018 to 2019. That's why net profit ratio or profit ratio is increased in 2019. And look on these 3 years. Gross profit in 2017 is 200,000, and in 2018 is 220,000. But the gross profit ratio decreased. So I'm telling you, do not focus on the real values. Calculate the ratios, then you will get the right answer. Because ratios are in the form of percentages, and the answer will be different as the actual values. So in 2019, the gross profit again increased to 245,000. In 2018, it is 220,000. But here, the gross profit ratio is increased in 2019. That's why the net profit ratio is also increased. So here, you can easily get the concept. The net profit ratio or profit ratio is directly proportional to gross profit ratio. Hopefully you got the explanation of this ratio, and you got a full understanding of these two factors which affect the net profit ratio or profit ratio. And in this situation, I am telling you, in these 3 years, I took the expenses to revenue ratio constant, and the value of expenses to revenue ratio in all 3 years is 37.5%. So there is no change in expenses to revenue ratio, but the gross profit ratio is variable and changing. First decreased in 2018 and then increased in 2019, and you can easily check the impact of this gross profit ratio on the net profit ratio. And remember, my students, I took expenses to revenue ratio in this example constant because I want to explain the impact of gross profit ratio on the net profit ratio. Hopefully you got the complete understanding of this topic. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section or on my WhatsApp number. Soon I will come with next video on next topic. Till then, Allah Hafiz. Bye-bye.